Today, we are going to add oral health and microbiome health. And I suppose we could generally call this oral and gut health, because as you know, if you think about it, your mouth, your oral cavity, and your gut are contiguous with one another.
Dr. Andrew Huberman, you were wrong. Never before have I shot a reaction video, but I cannot let this one go. Have you heard Dr. Huberman's recent oral health podcasts, 2 hours long? He gives some good information on there, but much of what he said is wrong and inaccurate. It's based on old data. What we know about oral health now, particularly oral health as it relates to your overall health, and can in fact save your life, he didn't even go there. He did say that he moved oral health up to be equivalent with his six pillars of health, along with sleep and movement and exercise and relationship. Great, Dr. Huberman, that is indeed where it belongs. But the information you gave us is just so disappointingly old and inaccurate. Let me give you the correct information. So he hinted at the fact that oral health could be related to overall health or to other health issues. But did you know that you can specifically know if your mouth, if your oral health is putting your body at risk with diseases that none of us want? In other words, your mouth can be contributing to, not just related to, but the health of your mouth or the disease of your mouth or lack of health in your mouth can be contributing directly to Alzheimer's disease, brain abscess, pregnancy complications, autoimmune disease, arthritis, and my expertise, cardiovascular disease. In fact, in 2013, the American Heart Association came out saying there is clearly enough evidence to know that 50% of heart attacks occur from an oral health issue. That was back in 2013. And since that time, we've had much more data come out, not only supporting the fact that oral health issues contribute to heart attack, contribute to stroke, vascular disease, and diabetes, but also defining the physiology and the pathophysiology of that and how does that happen. So if you want to improve your health, if you want to improve your life, if you want to have a long life and health span all the way to the end of your lifespan, then you have to understand oral health based on current data, accurate information. Dr. Huberman spent a lot of time talking about getting rid of over-the-counter mouthwashes. Great, that's true. They can oftentimes have harsh chemicals that sterilize the mouth and ultimately lead to an overgrowth of bacteria and other microorganisms that are problematic for systemic disease, those that we just outlined previously. But over-the-counter mouthwashes are not the only thing that we put in our mouth that can have harsh chemicals in it or that can be damaging to the oral microbiome. So in order to know if your oral health is where it needs to be, you have to have your saliva tested. Even if your gums are pink, you don't have periodontal disease, you don't have any mouth bleeding, your teeth are beautiful, your breath is great, you still must have a test where you spit in a tube. That's sent off to the lab. And with that, we can get a thorough understanding of the health of your oral microbiome, not just the presence of the dangerous bacteria. That's important. We have to know that because some of those dangerous bacteria get into the bloodstream and lead to these diseases like heart attack. But we need to know more than that about your mouth. And we can tell that from a saliva test, just a simple sample of your saliva. I don't think he even mentioned that. I didn't hear it. Did you? Besides that, a dentist and a dental hygienist that's on the cutting edge and that understands these relationships between oral health and overall body health, again, these diseases that none of us want, will do further testing to make sure that the way that you're breathing is or is not putting your mouth at risk for harboring bad bacteria and other pathogens that lead to disease. So Dr. Huberman focused a lot on strep mutans and teeth health. Okay, great, not unimportant, but it's not as important as focusing on the microorganisms that cause systemic disease, heart attack, stroke, brain abscess, failure of dental implants. The list goes on and on. It will improve part of the health of your teeth and of the oral microbiome. And it is important, of course, to brush and floss. Not the most important thing. You have to test or you don't know. You have to see a dentist and a dental hygienist that knows about these things and knows how to effectively treat you. It can be treated. That's the good news. But first, you have to know what's going on. Can't know that even if a highly trained dentist or dental hygienist does a physical exam, x-rays, CT scan, we still do not know exactly what's going on unless you give us saliva sample, spit in a tube. Most of us had heard about gastrointestinal GI health and how the microbiome, this environment from tongue to tail, needs to be balanced. We need to have more of the good bacteria and good organisms, probiotics, and none of or less of bacteria and pathogens that can be harmful in the GI tract for a whole host of reasons. Most of us have heard that before and understand that, and understand that oftentimes testing is needed in that scenario too. Well, the same is true for our mouth. The mouth is the first step in digestion. When we put food in our mouth or fluids in our mouth and we either swallow or we chew to start the digestion process, even when we first smell the food, that is the first step of digestion. So to wait until you have a GI issue, there's already been something going on orally. We know that. And so again, you need a test and testing to know if your breathing is putting your mouth at risk, if anything else is putting your mouth at risk, and is your mouth unhealthy to the point that these pathogens are present that lead to systemic disease. In my practice, I ensure that my patients have the best protection against particularly heart attack, stroke as well, diabetes, and vascular dementia. And I cannot do that without screening everyone with a saliva test, screening everyone with a home sleep study, because that also is directly related to your oral health. If you're not taking in oxygen appropriately through your nose all night long, well before someone has what we call full-blown sleep apnea, where you stop breathing in the night, you can have decreased oxygen throughout the night. And that alters the oral microbiome, changes the pH, such that these bacteria and pathogens that you don't want to live in your mouth are able to thrive in that environment. And then you're swallowing all of that. So that puts your GI system at risk as well. And those pathogens get into the bloodstream, and that's where they get to the vascular system and cause trouble. That can lead to heart attack, stroke, and other vascular diseases, renal failure, contribute to diabetes. So anyway, Dr. Huberman, let's talk about the most current data. Let's talk about what even the American Heart Association said in 2013. And since that time, numerous studies that have connected the dots between oral health, between airway health, breathing, and chronic disease, particularly the scary ones. The other thing that I want to say about Dr. Huberman's information is he led us to believe that everything can be controlled if we ask the right questions and if we adhere to a certain dental or oral care regimen at home. Number one, you cannot protect yourself from these chronic diseases or crisis situations with pregnancy complications, with stroke, with heart attack, etc., by adhering to a certain protocol at home. Your home protocol for the way that you take care of your mouth is incredibly important, but to try to figure that out from a podcast is just misleading. So again, you need to see a dentist, a dental hygienist, and the dentist and dental hygiene team needs to collaborate with your MD, DO, nurse practitioner, PA, your prevention-focused or longevity-focused medical team. If you have the dental team and then the non-dental medical team working together, then you're covered. They have to be on the cutting edge. They have to understand how to actually evaluate your oral health with a saliva test and other tests. The CT scan can be incredibly important. Yes, the exam is not to be thrown out. It's very important as well. I just want to make the point that you can look good and have good breath and have pink gums, beautiful teeth, and still have pathogens that are lurking that are putting the rest of your body at risk. So Dr. Huberman would love to have a conversation about current data and about life-saving testing and intervention regarding oral health as it relates to longevity, vital health, systemic diseases. Thank you, Dr. Huberman, for raising awareness of oral health, but let's set the record straight. There's so much more to know than what you told us in your 2-hour video based on old data.